Dundee obviously has a games heritage that goes back about 25 years, all the way to DMA design. Great games such as Lemmings and Grand Theft Auto were born in Dundee. Tag Games was formed in 2006. Prior to being in mobile, we were involved in console game development. We have a management team of five, but I think the great thing about Tag is that everyone here is involved in production. We've increased from about 10 people to 25 in the last year, so nice growth. Along the way, you know, people are starting to specialise in certain areas. The potential for growth is absolutely huge. I think there's 4 billion mobile phones globally. We've obviously got iOS, we have Android, Windows Phone 7. Social is very much at the heart of everything we do. Very few companies right now are making social games for mobile, but if you think about it, a mobile phone's always been connected and it's always been very social. If your game's great, your friends will talk about it. And to me, that's awesome. What's important to us is retaining customers for as long as possible, keeping them happy, keeping them entertained. And one of the key things I think for a lot of games companies is we need to realize that we're in the entertainment business and games are going to compete against TV and they're going to compete against online video and they're going to compete against music for people's time. I think if you look at a lot of the kind of graphics and the visual approach that a lot of social games companies have taken, it's very much 2D, it's kind of hand-drawn, and that's in some ways part of its appeal. And I think for Tag, one way in which we can really differentiate is to bring our skills and expertise in 3D to that space. So again, we still want to keep the aesthetic the same, it still will be clean, shiny, attractive, bright and colourful, but that extra layer of polish is something that immediately sets our games apart from maybe some of our competitors. I think 3D is something that people see and they're familiar with now. They accept it as a sign of good quality. So you look at a movie and it's a 3D animated feature, you know that that's going to have, you know, certain levels of production quality associated with it. And I think the same is true in games.
I'm Stuart Graham, heading up the creative side of the company, really. Juggling about 10 different products at the same time. So one of the big ones at the moment is a football card game. It's very, very art intensive. There's 3D elements, there's 2D elements, there's 3D real-time, 3D pre-rendered. When you're working on a small screen, you've got to use every pixel very, very carefully. All the textures in the entire game are on an image, 1,000 pixels by 1,000. Electric City is another city-based game where you create an environment, create a world, using 3DS Max. It'll block out a scene, we'll render it out, give it a nice wash, there's your pitch. We had a pile of MIDI assets from the publisher so we could emulate their look. Visually, because it's all pre-rendered, we can make it quite a rich environment. What we could do with their look is study it, analyze it, quickly mock it up in 3DS Max, send it over to them, they would give feedback. One of the other projects we're doing in Tag Games is a theme park style game. It will be a social game, it will be very much a multiplayer game, and very much an ongoing game that will need updating every week. Every week there'll be new content added to it. Gradjack Streets 2 is evolved hugely visually. This one will be fully 3D, it won't be pre-rendered, it'll be live 3D game. So every building, street, tree, car, truck, bus, person will be a 3D element in this game. So as far as software goes, we need it to do more than one thing. And I'm very comfortable knowing that the tools I have to use can do what I want to do. So with 3DS Max, we wanted to use the package that we were familiar with, has all the tools. We wanted something that was reliable, that we could trust.
For Fun Park, we're kind of going for a plastic kind of look, like the Playmobil type toys. When I first started trying to get the look was Log Flume. I'd just done a couple of tutorials at home before that, trying to learn 3DS Max, and I'm glad I did that because it was very helpful. That model set the look for a lot of other things within the park itself. At the moment I'm using Turbo Smooth quite a lot, so it's quite a nice feature just to get the kind of smooth plastic look, and also being able to customise your hotkeys as well, so I can see the final outcome while still modelling kind of lowish poly. And the animation that we're doing for Fun Park is quite basic. It's generally just hand animating the carts, rendering out single images for the animation, so exporting as Targa, so that we can recompile them back into After Effects. Within After Effects we have markers we can put in that also exports information. The programmers can make the roller coaster kind of go faster and slower.
But one of the reasons we bought multiple copies of 3DS Max is because we knew it pays its way. You can see where the money's spent.
Many people still download a game and buy a game based on a screenshot. It may not be in the back of a box, it might be on the App Store or on the Android Marketplace, but they're still judging your game on one static screen. 3D makes more of an impact than 2D. The biggest piece of positive feedback that we get back is when the people that are playing our games write to us and tell us how much they're enjoying that game. That to me is the payback for what we do. We want to make a game that's played by a billion people. It's that simple. It may not happen this year, it may not happen next year, but we'll keep going until it does happen.